37th annual Bethel Harriers 20-mile road race, sponsored once again by ASOS, the heating contractor for Llanelli. There are many characters there, already in shot. Robert Haberstier just received the best wishes from his wife. And now they're lining up the last few seconds before undertaking this grueling distance. They're off. Straight away, Izzy takes to the lead. Izzy, affectionately known, is the biggest rabbit of all. He's not a bad runner, actually, but he has this habit of leading every long-distance race away. I've been in many races and he's done the same. And when you consider he's running in the 45 to 49 age group, that's some feat. And to continue after this burst in a very respectable time is even more astonishing. Now coming past the Sutton Broughton family, and is he still holding a 10-15 yard advantage? Leading the next group, immediately after, is Robert Haberstier from Longwood, the favourite, Andy Robertson, from the Army AA, who was second to Andy Holden in the Bermuda Marathon over a hilly and hot spot. Andy Holden, who did 2 hours 17 minutes at Bermuda, is in centre picture. Just to his left is your commentator today, Pete Flatman, from City of Hull Athletic Club. At this stage, I'm personally trying to remain relaxed and not become involved in too hard a burnout. On my immediate left is Dolby of Harrogate AC. Robert Haberstier is still running quite easily on the inside with a rather high arm carriage. Dolby now takes the lead. He ran a personal best in the London Marathon of 2 hours 36 and also ran in the People's Marathon in Birmingham in 2 hours 34, so he's an improving runner. And here he is again, having a go. With a good shot coming round this corner onto Holden the High Road. Must congratulate Derek Pickering for his excellent photography, especially when this is his first ever time. The group now is about 8 to 10 strong and includes Andy Robertson, Keith Burney, Ramsden of Holmfirth in the yellow, Duncan Gaskell on the inside, and Al Smith of Ealing in the middle. Coming up past Jubilee Garage now, after about 3/4 of a mile, and the pace is certainly hotted up a bit. I'm running on the inside and trying to keep relaxed, and I'm just putting a little surge in here just to see if it might be my day again. Feeling quite easy at this stage, but you know there's a man in red, all red there, Andy Robertson, who also looks very easy. Steve Spinney there, number 11, coming up on the outside. This stage is just coming up to the mile mark. The time at the first mile was not an over break, 5 minutes 6 seconds. However, I think the last half a mile has been under 5 minute mile pace. And we're now approaching the roundabout, coming up to the Genesis, and you'll see that the sun is coming in and out of the clouds, but it's very warm, and at this stage I was already beginning to sweat a bit. Notice Andy Robertson took a nice easy run on the inside there. This stage is Sue Dolby, who had led the pace early on, just dropping off the back. But he had a brave effort, and there's a big group about 50 yards back, containing some quite useful runners. This stage I'm feeling very easy, I just have a quick look to see who's around me, and I see just the two people I expected to see, Robertson and Halderson. I keep warming the pace up. I'd rather not see that big groove around all the time, as I think the race will be between the three of us. At this stage, the only time possibly that we had Andy Robertson looking anything but supremely comfortable, and he said afterwards that he was sweating quite a lot in the first 2 miles. You'll just see now I'm putting on another little effort, and Duncan Gaskell is dropping back slightly, with Keith Denny and Elle Smith of Ealing. I have another look. Another look at Harbisher. He looks pretty relaxed there. And I think to myself, this is not the day when I can run it right from the gun. I'm beginning to stretch away now. I feel quite easy as we're coming around the Gansford lane. And at last, the only time Robertson just looks the slightest stretch is at this stage, if you could call it that. Beautiful sunny day. And the pictures, I think you'll agree, are very good. Too sunny now, just dropping off the back. Just trailing Smith and Duncan Gaskell. Duncan I've known for many years, since I first started running in 72. The pace has just eased off a bit. I've eased off the pedal a little bit. I wanted to see if somebody else would do something. And Richard Harbisher is about to oblige. And Robertson now looks comfortable again. Now coming up, we've got three gangsters towards Coniston. And with a slight backwind, or side backwind, it's feeling pretty warm. And the 10-mile mark seems a long way. Which is now taking the lead, although I don't think he's pushing on, I think he's going back a bit. You can see the two runners behind, Smith and Gaskill, are coming back onto the group. Something I wouldn't have wished. You see, Robert Haberty now is, it certainly eased the pace considerably. Although I must admit I didn't notice at the time. You see, Smith's feeling is now easily back onto the group and Duncan is just about to join him. As we go through, two spinners for Barnsley. Running well. Ramsden and Holmfirth. Looking gritty. Next group, led by Cook for Stainford. And in there is McKenzie, Dolby. Next group, Keith Steer. And we have a large group. It contains John Crossland and Trevor Shields. John Potter just coming through the picture now, and there's Irisy, still battling on bravely. Rod Train just goes through. Former winner of the East Old Trail for the 20 Mile Championship. Charlie Davison comes through now. John Towers, now one of the country's leading ultra distance runners. Bernie Child, looking relaxed. Graham Hart now surprisingly back in the pace, although I'm sure he'll pick it up later. Alan Sedman. Tom Hunter, great to see him back running. Jim Stones, indicating he's going to overtake, and that he does. There's screams of runners now coming through. It's been a good field really. 140 entries, over 110 starters. You consider their usual advertising was not quite up to it, it's very good. Three more East Hull runners just go through. Don Devaney, City of Hull, first Carol Bowl comes through now. He's got a long way to go. So the very compact group, including Bert Cooper.